there's probably a point where you keep getting the FabFitFun boxes and you keep getting kind of some of the same products and you're like, is this really worth it for me? Hello, welcome back to my channel. Thank you so much for joining me today. Today I'm here to open up my spring FabFitFun box for 2020. This is one of my favorite things to get in the mail. If you're not aware, FabFitFun is a quarterly subscription box that gives you full-size products, beauty, lifestyle, health and fitness, like all kinds of things. And the best part about it is that you get to customize and you get to pick certain things. That for me makes it worth it because then I know that everything coming in my box is something that I'm gonna use. Yeah, there are always a couple things that they throw into everybody's boxes that are surprise, something that you don't know about or that you didn't pick, but everything else I got to pick, which makes the value of the box totally worth it for me. The price of the box is $50. If it is your first time, I have a link down below that gets you $10 off. It's also a referral link. You get $10, I get $10 back towards one of my future boxes. They also have an annual option where you can pay for the whole year in advance. That gives you an additional $5 off for each box, and it gives you more options to pick for each quarterly box. So as we go through the box, I'll tell you which items everybody got to pick, which items just the annual subscribers got to pick, and then which items FabFitFun picked and just put in our box. I'm so excited to open this. The other thing is that you always pick them like way far in advance, so I don't remember what I picked. I even watched an unboxing already. There is a channel that I like to watch sometimes for beauty reviews because she's really into ingredients, and I always watch her FabFitFun unboxings because she kind of talks about the ingredients that are in each of the products and whether she thinks the value of the box is worth it, and she gets the box sent to her. I'll leave her channel and that FabFitFun video linked below if you're interested in checking that out. All right, let's go ahead and open it up. Oh, the inside is beautiful too. The outside this month is also beautiful. So this is what it looks like when you first open it up. It always comes with a magazine. It does a great job explaining the products. It gives you some ideas on how to use them. It has a couple articles in there as well. The most important pages though are what all the other options were. That way I can tell you as we are going through the box. So where are these pages? Okay. All right, let's start with the products that everybody got to pick from, no matter what kind of subscriber you are. The best thing about FabFitFun as well is that you can still get this box. As of the time that I'm uploading this video, you can still go get this box on their website. I will caveat that sometimes some of the options that I talk about are unavailable if they've sold out, but usually you can still get a pretty good selection of items. It's not gonna be just one. So the item that I picked in this category is the Murad Rapid Collagen Infusion. I recently went to an event with Olay where they had a dermatologist talk about the rate at which our skin loses collagen and the fact that it's like impossible to get it all back, and that's how we get wrinkles and bags and all those things. And it kind of freaked me out a little bit. So when I saw this as one of the options, I was like, yes, please, I would like this. It says that you can use AM or PM, massage over clean face. Comes in a little bottle like this. It is a full-size bottle. I'm not sure how long it's gonna last me, but I am really excited to use this. This was probably one of the things I was the most looking forward to. And it says that the value of this is $78. You heard me, $78. Even if I love this, I likely will not be repurchasing it, but the fact that even if I paid 50 bucks for the box, and because I'm annual, I actually get a slight discount, this already paid for itself. The other things that you could have gotten in this category were a CalPak set of 3 packing cubes, and you got to pick between 2 different patterns. I already had packing cubes, so this didn't seem like something that I would need. You could also pick a Shoshana umbrella. This is a super cute umbrella, but I have my Erin Condren Mid-Century Circles one. The next thing you could pick was the Tarte Rainforest of the Sea Drink of H2O Hydrating Boost Moisturizer. That was a lot of words. I just didn't really feel like this was necessary. I sometimes struggle, and this is probably like a huge blanket statement, probably not totally true, but I struggle when brands do both makeup and skincare. I sometimes feel like focus on one and be really good at that one. And so the fact that it was a moisturizer from what I think of as a makeup brand, it just felt kind of weird to me. Because the next item was also from Tarte that you could pick in this category, and that was the Pro Glow Highlight and Contour Palette. I already have this, so I got it during one of the Ulta 21 Days of Beauty sale, and truthfully, I don't really use it all that much. I love one of the highlighters. I go for it a lot. The other products in this palette are waste. And then the last option in this category was the Rose Gold Radiance Booster. I did not pick this because I feel like I have naturally oily skin, and so anything that's kind of usually like a glow boost is not something that I need. However, the value of this item is $135. So if you are really trying to get the most value out of your FabFitFun box, you should have picked that product. All right, the next thing that I chose, clearly I was on a skincare kick, is this Peptide Night Recovery Oil from Elemis. I've never heard of this brand. But it says advanced skincare. It says it's a night cream oil. I kind of like the combination of cream and oil because, again, I feel like sometimes I have oily skin. And I know that doesn't mean that I can't use oil. I do actually like to use marula oil on my skin at night sometimes, especially in the winter. But I like the idea of a cream oil combo. And this just, I don't know, this seemed really nice and fancy. And you'll see there was nothing else in this category that I really wanted. It's a glass bottle, so super nice, high quality. Again, another small size, like, can see like the small size comparison, but I feel like for skincare products they're usually this size. It says that the value for this product is $59, so together we're already at well over $100. Totally worth it. The other options in this category was a Revive Light Therapy Wrinkle and Anti-Aging Light Device. So it was one of those like lights that you stick over your skin to like help with wrinkles. I didn't feel good about doing this at home. That one did interest me a little bit, but it made me really nervous to do at home. And after watching Jen's review, the person I talked about at the beginning, after watching her review of that product, because that's what she got, I'm very glad that I did not get it. The next one was a sweater. I was tempted to get this, but one size fits all really makes me nervous. So I liked the look of the sweater, but I wasn't gonna trust one size fits all. The next one was a diamond woven rug. We don't need any other rugs, and this didn't really look like it would go in our apartment. You could also get a tote, which I feel like they offered in another FabFitFun. I feel like this was in a summer box, like a summer tote. I definitely don't need any more totes. And then the last option in this category were these West Elm Indigo tie-dye bowls. These were also from a past FabFitFun box, and actually, so was that Tarte Pro Glow palette. I didn't end up picking it that time. I got it at Ulta, but I feel like I'm seeing a lot of repeats this quarter, like things that you could have picked from the past one, which kind of makes me feel weird. Like, are they just pairing up with this company again? There were a lot more options. I will say, like, both of these categories had 6 options, which is a lot, I feel like, compared to past FabFitFun boxes. But at the same time, some of them are repeats from past boxes. So if you're a repeat subscriber, then you're obviously not going to pick those. On the other hand, I guess it's good if you're brand new and you were like, oh, I missed out on that Tarte palette and now I want it. I can see both sides. Okay, the next thing that I picked was this weighted sleep mask. And I picked it because I love my weighted blanket. It has been just such a relaxing part of my evening routine that I thought, oh my gosh, a weighted sleep mask would be so awesome. I use a sleep mask now, so I'm used to having something on my face at night, and a weighted one just feels like it would be so nice. Well, I will tell you, I watched Jen's review of this. She also got this in her box. And it was not positive, and I am having the same feelings, just initially feeling this. So the first thing is the beads, like the what's inside feels so uneven. Like it doesn't feel like flat, like it would feel flat against my face. The other bigger problem that she talked about is that it does not stay in place if you move and sleep on your side. So if you're a back sleeper, it's probably not that big of a deal. But if you sleep on your side or if you move in your sleep, like it flops around, which I guess makes sense. So I don't know. I don't know if I'm really going to use this product, and it's kind of a huge bummer that I picked it. So this category was kind of a dud for me. So the other options in this category were a necklace duo set, which looked really pretty, but I have plenty of necklaces, as you can see, so I didn't feel like I needed that. You could also pick this mask collection. Again, I have a lot of masks. I get a lot of them from FabFitFun too, and I'm trying to use my products, not necessarily add to the collection. It's not helping. The next thing you could pick was this Cosmetics Pure C, where you added a dose of acid to your nighttime serum or moisturizer. I liked the idea of this. I clearly had already picked some nighttime products or some face products. And at the same time, I didn't like the idea of having to add things. I just want a product that I can just put on my face. And then the last thing in this category that you could pick was this hibiscus plant-based body scrub. I actually already have a couple body scrubs that I'm trying to work through, so I knew I didn't need this. This category, I was excited about the sleep mask, but truthfully, this category was just kind of like meh for me. There was nothing in there that was gonna be new or exciting. Stuff I would use, like I would use the mask probably, I would use the body scrub, but I already have those products anyways and I didn't need to add more to them. I feel like there's probably a point where you keep getting the FabFitFun boxes and you keep getting kind of some of the same products and you're like, is this really worth it for me? So like that category is definitely one of those items. Now, the first two categories, did I need those skincare products? I guess not necessarily, but it's a really good value. And you'll see, we also got some products that I am really excited about that I think are good new additions or replacements of things in my house. So those were the categories that everybody got to pick. The next two items, only annual members got to pick. So if you sign up for the annual subscription, you got to pick between these two. Otherwise, FabFitFun just put one of these in your box. So the first thing that I picked was a new hairbrush. And I was really excited about this because my hairbrush probably could have been replaced a long time ago. I've had it for a very long time. Oh, I can see myself. Oh, I love this. This is beautiful. So it's, oh, you can see, hello camera. It is rose gold. I will tell you though, it feels a little bit cheap. Like, it doesn't feel like it has a lot of weight to it. It just feels kind of like flimsy, and I don't know. I'm excited about it. And the truth be told, like, my hairbrush doesn't have a lot of weight to it either. It's also a cheap hairbrush. So it's not necessarily like a downgrade from my hairbrush, but I was kind of hoping it was gonna be a little bit more of an upgrade. It's beautiful. Like, this would be good for staging photos, but it's not necessarily, I don't know, it doesn't feel all that great. I don't know, whatever. What is the value of this brush? $35, no way. The other options in this category was a body oil. I didn't feel like I need this. Again, I have a lot of body lotions that I'm trying to work through anyways. I'm so bad about putting on body lotion consistently. The next item was tea towels. This just didn't feel necessary. We have plenty of towels. The next one was this Aveda Daily Hair Care Repair. I own this already from a FabFitFun box. Again, with the repeats. And that was it. Those were the options. So, I mean, I'm really glad that I got to pick because the brush is definitely better than the other ones for me. This is not shaping up to be one of my favorite boxes. Okay, so I'm a little bit confused about the next category because the item that I got, and I checked on the website, like that is what I chose, and it sounds like something I would pick. I don't see it in the magazine. I don't know if it's just a typo in the magazine and they messed it up. But I can't find it in the magazine. So I don't know that it's actually an option. And it is this makeup finishing spray from Skindinavia. And again, when I go look on the website, this is listed as like what is supposed to be in my box in order of the items, the categories listed in the magazine, but it's not in the magazine. So I will look up how much it's worth, but like, I don't think you're gonna be able to pick this. I have no idea. Supposedly the items you could pick from in this category were hair fast food leave-on conditioner. I have two leave-in conditioners that I'm working through, one with heat protectant and one without. I try to use the appropriate one, so I definitely wouldn't have chosen that. The next option was a hand wash, which we just got hand wash. I'm pretty sure that was the last one, so I have that in my sink right now. The next one was a body wash. I have plenty of body wash, actually not from FabFitFun. I got some at the Olay event that I went to. The next option was a Bluetooth speaker. We've had this option before. It wasn't this exact brand, but it was a different Bluetooth speaker. We don't need that. I mentioned in the last FabFitFun that the speaker was an option. And what I do is I put my phone in the sink and it acts as like a natural speaker. And my bathroom is small enough that as long as I shut the door and put the phone in the sink, I can hear it in the shower. The next option was a liquid liner. I could maybe have seen myself picking this. In fact, when I couldn't find what I got in the category, I went to my account and that's what I thought I might have picked because I can always use another liquid black liner. I'm not super picky or like married to any one brand. And so I kind of thought that might be it, but nope, it's not. And then the last one was a salt and pepper grinder. This has definitely also been an option before. I am incredibly disappointed that there are so many repeats. All right, the last three items FabFitFun picked. And what's interesting, in the past, usually this section where FabFitFun picked, everybody got the same item. And that is not the case this season. This season, there are lots of options, but not options. Like FabFitFun just got to pick. It still usually is three items, but usually it's consistent across everybody's box. So it's gonna be interesting to see if I get some of the same stuff that like the YouTubers that I watch unbox them get, because they get them for free sent to them. I think I usually watch three people unbox their FabFitFun, all of whom get it sent to them for free versus what I get, because I purchased this myself, but I am a select member. So maybe there's certain things that, you know, they give the select member a better option. I don't know. So the first item is this Deep Sleep Body Cocoon. I am really excited about this because I am always down for something that's gonna help me sleep better. I'm not sure if it's for your face or, nope, it says massage nightly into hands and body and breathe in deeply. So it's probably more about like the scent to help you sleep rather than like actual products being in it for your skin. Oh yeah, it has that like, you know, that scent It kind of smells like a spa, has a lot of lavender in it. This is really interesting. It's got a lot of ingredients though, which I feel like is probably not a great thing, but I'm really excited about this. I definitely will be using this. Like, that's going straight on my nightstand. The other thing they could have picked for you, which is what I saw a lot of the YouTubers get, is a mask. And it's from Wish, Wish Beauty, W-H-I-S-H. And it is a blue matcha restoring mask valued at $58. I am happy that I got the sleep thing. Okay, the next thing that I got, I'm actually really excited. I think this is gonna be my favorite item from the box, and that is a set of silicone straws. If you know me at all, I am a strawaholic. And at home, I do a good job of using reusable straws. I use like thick plastic ones because I don't like the taste of metal straws. So I use reusable plastic. They're like thick plastic ones that I put in the dishwasher. I'm excited about these silicone ones because they come with a little carrying case. And that is where I know I don't do as good of a job in the world. If they have a paper straw, I will always take the straw. If they only have plastic straws, I will think about it. If I know I am dehydrated and I really need to hydrate, sometimes I just take the plastic straw, y'all. But I'm excited to have these silicone ones to put in my little case and take with me. I hope that, I mean, I'm assuming they don't get messed up. Like, you know, they're supposed to be bent like this to put them in here and then take them with you. So freaking cool. And it comes with a straw cleaner. Comes with four different colors, little case. Super, super excited about this. Again, this is probably my favorite item, which is probably worth $15. My favorite item in the whole box, worth a whopping $15. The other things they could have picked for you were the Wander Beauty Mile High Volume and Length Mascara. I have tried this mascara. I don't think it was FabFitFun. I think it might have been another beauty subscription box. I have canceled them all at this point. I'm not really sure, but I know I didn't really like this mascara. It did add lengthening and it was good for like a second layer of separating my lashes, but it did not add any volume in my opinion. And then the last thing in this category was a body wash infused buffer, which is interesting. We don't need body wash because I have a lot of it right now, but having it infused in something is kind of a cool idea. I probably would have been happy with that as well, but I am super excited about the straws. Okay, and then the last thing that I got was this Pure Lease Watermelon Energizing 2-Minute Peel. I mean, I'm excited about this. I mentioned I don't need really any more masks, but this seems like something a little bit different. I don't really have very many peels. I used to have one from First Aid Beauty that was a peel. Otherwise, most of my masks are either like a hydrating sheet mask or like a gunk-sucking clay mask. So this is exciting and it's super cute. All the watermelon, this feels very springy. I haven't really commented on if this box feels springy or not. I don't really feel like it does. In the past, I feel like sometimes it's a little bit more geared towards the season, but this definitely feels springy. It says gently resurfaces skin smoothing boost radiance. So you put it over your skin, you let it sit for 2 minutes, and then you, oh, it just says rinse with water. That doesn't feel like a peel. I feel like peel, I'm gonna peel it off. That's what I did with the First Aid Beauty one. But this one, it just says you rinse. It says great for everyday use. I haven't seen any other YouTubers get this product either, so I don't know if they have any thoughts on it either. I'm excited to try it, but probably not like the most exciting thing in my box. The other options in this category was a lip balm. That's something I probably actually would have used. It's $18. I would never pay $18 for a lip balm, but that's a super useful item. And then the last thing in this category was the Aveen Thermal Spring Water, which I definitely don't need a full size of this. I have a travel size that I got in another beauty subscription box, and I like it. It just feels like you're spraying water on your face. I actually put it in my international travel bag. I have like a Ziploc of all these things that I want to have on the plane when I'm traveling internationally to help me with super long flights, and keeping my skin moisturized is one of those things. So again, it just feels like water on your face, and I have it so that I can spray it on my face during those long flights to keep myself hydrated. But I'm glad that I didn't get a full size, especially because it's a spray can like that. I'm not gonna take the full size on the plane. I probably can't take the full size on the plane. All right, if you can tell, I'm pretty disappointed this season. I felt like FabFitFun had a lot of repeats from prior seasons. I felt like there was a mistake with the either with my what came in my box or what was on the magazine. It didn't feel as luxurious as it does in the past. I mean, I got some high quality skincare products that I'm excited to use, but that brush was super disappointing. And like the most exciting item for me was a $15 pack of silicone straws. It just feels, again, not as luxurious. And that's one of the reasons that I like my FabFitFun subscription. So I'm kind of disappointed. According to my calculations, the value of my box was $331. But I'm not excited about all of the items, so it doesn't really feel like that for me. If I was to calculate it based on the items that I am really excited about, it would be the two skincare products, the sleep lotion, oil stuff, and the straws, which value at $192. So is that still greater than the $45 I paid for the box? Yes, it is. So I'm still satisfied with what I got, but I'm definitely disappointed because in the past I've been excited about all the items and this season I'm definitely not. If there are some things that you are really excited about and it's your first one, use that $10 off code and for $40 you can still get a high value, get that $135 product. Let me know in the comments what you think. Which item in this box would you be most excited to try? Let me know. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new here, please click that subscribe button. I upload new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Happy planning. That was weird. Oh my God, I forgot to freaking cut it. The next one was a rug, a hand wash, which we just, and then the last thing in this month, I'm definitely, not month,